Am I audible? Okay, fine. Yes. So we were talking about the density of states in which we saw this final equation. Okay, so that was about this ZEDE, and we saw this ZEDE upon V, where this A was getting cancelled. Okay, so many students had the doubt also that this is for the volume and this one is for the acceleration, right? So how it has got cancelled? So actually, there is minor update in this. According to the Schrodinger's equation, when we are talking about the sound wave, at that time, this A is for the acceleration, okay? And this A is for the volume. When we will be talking about the electron's energy potential, this will be getting changed. So here, this small a is for interatomic distance. Means suppose electron is there, which is moving in different path. So one atom molecule is there, second atom molecule is there, it can be ion also, anything. So wherever the electron is actually moving, this distance is known as small a. That is interatomic distance where the free electron is moving. Okay, then after it will be getting collision. And this small a is again, we saw the potential well box, okay, in which we saw A, B and C. Okay, so same way the electron's path, which we were initially covering for the 1/8 part only, but when we see this thing in the 3D portion, at that time it will be one full unit, right? So that is for the unit volume, and they have considered this distance as A, and once again it is interatomic distance in one dimensional, but we are considering the volume in 3D, that's why it has been taken as A cube. So the updation is that in the last lecture that, just a minute, here we have to deal with A is equal to interatomic distance. Okay, so just note it down. This A is for interatomic distance. Now in the volume also it has been considered. That's why it's getting deleted. Okay, any more doubt for the density of the states? When we are talking about the sound wave energy, only for the sound wave energy, this is for the acceleration. But here the Schrodinger's equation for the electron potential is changed, and that is given via this small a, which is known as the interatomic distance. All right. Any more doubt from your side regarding this equation? Just update that in your textbook also if it is written as acceleration, because it's no more an acceleration for the electron wave potential. Okay. It is for interatomic distance. All right. So is it clear to everyone? Yeah. So we will be moving forward with one more topic, and that is regarding, today we will see about the chronic panel model, all right? So just note it down, this one, A is for the next thing, this final equation, how we have got this, A is getting cancelled because this is interatomic distance, all right? Okay. Okay, so now the next concept is about the chronic panel model, how it actually works. Okay, so this model is again one advanced concept about what we have studied so far in the density of states also. Okay, both A are interatomic distance. Yes, here both A are interatomic distance because in the potential well also, that is the one dimension of x-axis where the electron is moving freely. Okay, so in three dimensions, it is taken as interatomic distance. All right. So that is how we are dealing with it. Okay. So now the next topic is about the chronic panel model. So what is the chronic panel model that we will see today? Just remember that in density of states, whenever you are talking about sound wave, then only it's acceleration, otherwise interatomic distance. Okay. So in chronic panel model, the first content is about the model itself. So it was proposed by the Ralph Chronic and William Panet. It is a simplified model for an electron for one-dimensional periodic potential. Here they are talking about the periodic potential. Periodic potential in the sense, electrons will be having the energy in the repetitive measure. Okay, sometimes it's low, sometimes it's high, sometimes it can get even higher, then it can get lower, and once again it can get lower, right? So if I connect this point, can I generate a wave like this? Okay, and it will be repeated again and again. So that is one kind of periodic pattern, okay? So which is getting repeated, right? So simplified model for an electron for this is shown like this. Now there are some illustrative tools also to find the allowed energies and forbidden energies in this model. Up till now we were talking about how much electrons can be there in energy band. Okay, that was done via the density of solids. But if I want to know that which kind of energy is there, how much energy is there in the electron, what are the energy gaps. If I want to understand that, at that time this chronic Panay model will be used. Okay, so it helps in understanding different concepts. So what are the assumptions for this chronic Panay model? Up till now, we were considering that only the electron is getting the collision. Okay, we saw a 3D potential well, we saw the sphere also. So we just saw that electron may get collided with each other, their energy may be different. But there will be a case where there will be some ions also. Okay, so if you see in real crystal, there are some periodical arrangement for positively charged ions. Okay, through which the electrons can also move. Okay. Okay, there is one doubt regarding the periodic potential that will be covered now in the graph. Okay, we will see the whole pattern for the periodic. Okay, don't worry about that. Yes, so normally what happens, electrons are moving not only in the direction opposite to the applied electrical field, but whenever they will be moving, there will be some positively charged ion also. These are the positive ions. Now, what are the ions? Suppose there are one material is there, so thousands of molecules will be there in that. Okay, so what happens in this molecule? Valence electron from this molecule may get out in the material. Okay, so whenever electron is lost from the valence band, it will be positive ion. Now suppose this electron is going to the one another molecule, so at that time in the valence band they are accepting the electron, so that will be negative ion. Okay, this concept was about the chemistry. So these positive ions can also be there in the lattice structure, okay, crystal lattice structure. So if electron is moving freely in a material, it can get collided with this also, right? So that is the basic assumption for this model. That previous assumption was inside the box, only electrons are moving in constant potential energy. But now inside a real crystal, according to this model, electrons move between the ions. Okay, so now they are trying to say the next thing is potential of electrons at the positive ion will be zero and in between the maximum. Now what they are trying to say, suppose electron is moving from here, it has entered from here, it has start moving here, now it has gotten collided. Somewhere they will be having some energy here, some higher value will be there. Now when suppose one thing is moving, it's coming, it's having some higher energy, it's getting collision. Means at that time it will be steadily stopped. Okay, for some moment it will be stopped. Now again it will be bouncing, going like this. Okay, anywhere it will be going. So what is happening? Initially it was zero, it's getting higher. Now once it's collided, it's again getting low and zero. Now once again, because the electrical field is there, it will be either bounced back or going into different direction. So once again from zero to higher energy is getting. Okay, we are just talking about a simple object. Same happens with the electron also. Suppose these are the positive ions. So electron is coming from here, the free electrons are coming, it's getting collided. Now initially it was having some energy. Okay, when it is collided, it will be stopped for some moment. Okay, so that energy which was initially very high, that is getting lower, it can be zero also. From this zero, because the electrical field is applied, electrical field in the sense, the battery terminal is there, okay? So according to this field, again, it will catch up some momentum. Again, it will be catching up some energy, okay? And it will be again going higher, either this side or through the material, or we can say in the opposite direction. Normally what happens, it tries to go from the negative to positive terminal, that is opposite to the applied electrical field, right? That is what the basic happening here. So that concept is shown that potential energy of electrons between the positive ions will be maximum because here the electrons are moving. But when it will be at the positive ion, means when it is getting collided, at this point it will be zero. Okay, for all the free electrons, whenever it's getting collision, at this point their energy will be zero, then it will be getting higher. In between also higher because they are moving, right? Initially also they will be higher. When the collision is there, then only it will be stopped. So these are the assumptions for the chronic Panay model, that electrons are not only moving in between electrons only, but they are having the ions also. And at the ions, when the collision is occurring, their energy is getting zero. Okay, and once again, it will be maximum when once again it is getting traveling. All right, so that is how this model is working. So you can see here the motion of the electron. So normally what happens whenever we are talking about the higher energy, that is considered as infinite sometimes, okay? So it is possible that outside this crystal potential, the energy can be infinite. Means if it is getting out of the material, definitely it will be very much higher, okay? So this is for the periodic potential. Now, what is actually the periodic potential? Let us see that. You can see this figure, okay? So what is periodic potential? A pattern which is getting repeated Okay, the energy pattern which gets repeated is known as the periodic potential pattern. Periodic in the sense something that is getting repeated over some time. Okay, so you can see here initially, suppose this one is the point zero and this one is some point V. Okay, initially the energy is starting from the zero. Okay, initially the energy is highest because we are applying the voltages. Okay, now the electron which was having the higher energy is getting near to the ion. You can see here the electron is getting near to the ion. So what happens, its energy will be initially higher, but it will be getting zero when it will be collided with the positive ion, right? So the energy graph, if I see the electron which was initially having some high energy, now the ion is there. Okay, this ion is there, the electron has collided with this. Means its energy was quite high, but now it's getting lower, right? So in the graph, I can show it like this, okay? So at this point, where the ion is there, it will be zero, okay? Now, once again, due to the electrical field which I have connected with my material, they will again try to move from the negative to positive terminal, right? So it will again gain some energy, okay? This energy will be again getting lower when one more ion will be there in the vein, it will be getting collided. So you can say these points are zero and these points are getting high. So that is one pattern which is getting repeated over a time. So that is known as the periodic potential energy, which Kronig-Penney model has proposed. Okay, so is it clear, Dev? What is this periodic potential? A pattern of energy potential that is getting repeated over a period of time. All right, 51 number, is it clear to you now? Yes, okay. So now these things, again, it is not always possible that this energy will be same at the higher level almost. But in most of the material, it will be same. Okay, now one more query is there. If electron collide with another electron, then also the energy comes to zero like ions. Yes, then also the energy will be coming to zero like ions. So most of the structure, the electrons as well as the positive ions, this collision will definitely be in this periodic pattern. Okay, so somewhere the electrons are also here, you can see here. So that's why this pattern may change also. Okay, and for that the different equations are there, because electrons and holes both are there, right? So this is the potential energy variation. Now they have shown this concept about how the electron is actually moving. You can see here. Okay, here this one is the interatomic distance, interatomic in the sense, suppose one molecule is here, second molecule is here. The electron which is passing from this to this, this is known as this distance A. Okay, now they have taken one more distance also. So it can be possible that it may move in the different direction also. Okay, some are going here, some are going there. So atomic distance are shown in one X, that is this axis is X axis. Okay, on which they have shown the positive side of the direction of electron movement also and negative direction of electron movement also. Okay, this minus sign are not the minus distances, they are for the direction. So we can plot the energy in both the ways. Some electrons will be moving in same direction, some will be in the different. Okay, so this has been just represented in a graph. So whenever the energy is getting zero, you can see this kind of region where the energy was getting zero, where it was getting zero, where the ions were there, right, where the positive ions were there. So at that time, these things will be known as the barriers. Okay, these are the potential barriers. Barriers in the sense, these are hard to cross, no currents can be there, right, because the energy is getting zero. And the rest of the region is potential well that we imagined as a box, as a sphere, right, where the current is actually getting passed. Okay, so two regions will be there here. One will be the potential barrier, second will be the potential well. Now in the Kronig-Penney model, three graphs are there in your textbook. Okay, first one is showing the motion of the electrons in one dimensional. You can see these are the ions and the electron is moving from here to here. All right, so you can see this point is zero, it's getting higher. Suppose this is Vx point, initially higher energy due to the electrical field, it's getting lower when the it's getting collision with the ions. They have shown them in the waveform. Okay, this is for the one dimension, that's why all the energy levels are showing same. It can be varying in the density. Okay, because when the collision will be with another free electron and all, at that time it will be changing, but this is the normal pattern in every material. Now in your textbook, second graph is also shown like this. That is the rectangular approximation. Means if I want to convert this wave into a rectangular pattern, I can convert it like this. But here there is a mistake in the textbook. You can see where the point is zero, they are showing some highest peak. Okay, this one is correct. The highest peak is shown with the highest rectangular. Here, when once again it's getting zero, okay, this one is perfect. Again, this is zero, but they have shown it as a higher peak. Okay, what is rectangular approximation? The wave which I have connected, now I'm just representing it with a this kind of column chart. Okay, that is a rectangular approximation. So what will be happening here? It will be changed here. Just a minute. Okay, we will take this one here. Okay, this wave will be changed now. Okay, so you just have to update that in your textbook also. This wave will be changed. Okay, initially it will be considered as a zero. Okay, initially this will be considered as a zero. Okay, so this graph will be like it is starting from the highest range. Okay, then it's getting lower. Again, we are getting the rectangular pattern approximately to this. This point is higher. We have to match this wave. Okay, then again, it's getting low. Okay, just imagine it as a perfect rectangular. Okay, so this graph will be something like this. Okay, then only it will be correct. So you just have to make sure whenever you are drawing this in the examination also, here, wherever the positive ions are there, you have to show it as the zero range. You can see the zero is shown in the graph. Okay, these three are in the interlinked concepts. Okay, so this graph will be like this. Where these positive ions are, you have to show it as zero. And this zero will be shown as this lower rectangle in this graph. Right? So just make sure that whenever you draw these two things, potential energy variation as well as the rectangular approximation, it should be matching to each other. Wave pattern is transferred to this kind of columns. Okay, now what is the use of the rectangular approximation? Now what happens whenever you are talking about a wave? Wave energy have different mathematical equation. Okay, that deals with the Schrodinger. But when I want the solution of this, it is quite complicated for a wave to find a perfect solution. So what we are doing, we are now converting it into the rectangular. So this function will be varying. Suppose you will be aware about the sine and cosine waves, right? Sine function waves like sine 0 is 0, but cos 0 is 1. So their wave function is different, right? So when I'm talking about the waves, the equation changes as per its shape. But when I'm talking about the rectangular approximation, it will be easier to count for the varying potential because the function will be different now. The Schrodinger equation will get changed now. So that is the reason why we are using now the rectangular approximation. Is it clear, Cheyenne? Okay, then second question is collision between ion and electron will be elastic. Okay, here when the ions are actually getting collided with electron, yes, all the collisions are elastic here because we have approximated it as a free electron theory from the gas molecule theory, right? So basically all the collisions are considered elastic here. Normally what happens is somewhere inelastic collision can also be there. So for that, radiation will be occurring in the later on chapters content. Okay, some excessive energy will also be getting emitted. So that concept will also be cleared, right? So currently we have to assume that ions and electrons are getting elastic collision. So no energy loss is there. The energy is getting balanced. Okay. Is it clear, Drishti? 59 number. Okay. All right. Fine. So we were moving with this. Why we have converted it into this? Because the rectangular functions will be much easier to calculate regardless of wave function. So now initially we were having the Schrodinger's equation. Now the two regions are there as we have seen. The first one where it's getting zero, the potential is zero, means it's getting collision, their energy is getting zero. At that point we can write it as this barrier. It is a barrier because no electron current will be there. Second one is the potential well, because here the electric current will be there, because if its electron is having some energy, then only it will be moving. And if it is moving, then the current is passed. Okay, if it is zero, it's not moving, the current is not passed. So where the region where current is not there, it's known as a barrier, one kind of hurdle, right? And the well is constituted of the different energies. Okay, so here we are having the Schrodinger's equation, that is d square psi upon dx square, that we have already seen. So for zero less than x less than f, means for this region it is considered like this because the potential is zero. So this V is eliminated. In the second equation, again, E minus V terminology was there, but here there is some value, there is some potential, that's why V is not 0, okay? Initially in the equation here, we were having E minus V into psi is equal to 0, right? If you remember the Schrodinger's equation, it is taken as 0 for the barrier region, and for other region, there will be some value which they have taken into consideration as V0, okay? So that is what the model is proposing. Now the Schrodinger's equation, this one for the rectangular pattern, it will be changed, okay? Because we are converting wave into the periodic potential now. So the psi equation about the Schrodinger will be reinvented now. It will be reformed in this way, okay? So this is the periodic function through which I can find this rectangular wave pattern, all right? And this is the plane function in which the one dimension I have taken into consideration the electron's movement, okay? So that is one more equation. Yes, you have to remember this equation because that is directly given in the textbook as well, and it will be asked in the exam also, that explain the Kronig-Penney model, okay? So just remember this equation. There are no supportive theories for this, that how this equation has been there, all right? But they have directly mentioned this periodic function, okay? So whenever I want to convert my wave pattern into the rectangular pattern, at that time I have to use this equation of the Schrodinger in reformation. Okay, so this is for the periodic wave pattern, means if I want to find that in which region my electron will be moving, at that time I can find it with UK, that is periodic, and plane function means in which one dimension my electron is moving. You can see here, okay, these are the ions and this is the interatomic distance. So that is how this equation has been given. Now for the solution of this equation with a boundary, one more equation is coming, okay? There will be always in mathematics some boundary limits, okay? If you have gone through the partial differential equation and something, in there always some boundary conditions are always there, okay? In the integration also, if you mention 0 to x or 0 to infinite, there are some boundary conditions for any particular function, that how this function will be working well, in which boundary it's showing its proper output and everything, right? So for boundary condition purpose, the solution of the equation becomes this. So this is the previous equation, this one's solution, which is once again an equation, okay? So psi of x uk e, then this is in the exponential form, means it will be rising as per the energies getting raised, okay? So here one more solution is there regarding sine and cosine function. You can see here, that is p into sine alpha a upon alpha a. They have used Bloch theorem, applying the boundary condition for the solution of Schrodinger equation. For what? For the Kronig-Penney model, where we are calculating the energy bands. Okay. So here we can get this equation. It is directly given. You don't need to go in depth. You just have to remember that this is the solution of the previous one. Okay. Here they have mentioned the P. So what is actually this P? Okay. That is given by this equation, MV0BA upon H cut square, where P is the scattering power of the potential barrier in the sense where the potential energy is getting zero, you know, that lower one rectangular graph. All right. Here they have shown V0B as the barrier strength, that is showing how much barrier is there. Okay. And H cut is the reduced Planck constant, that is H upon 2 pi. Okay. They have taken sine and cosine function. Why? Because here the wave patterns are there, right? So they have taken alpha A and Ka. All right, so this A is again regarding the interatomic distance. Alpha value will be taken for the wave angles, okay, among the different values, pi, pi by 2, and everything will be taken. So that is how this equation has came. No supportive theory has been given in the textbook as well. But you just have to remember that the previous equation with a boundary condition is having this solution, okay? Last two topics you can see in this first unit is getting complicated. The density of states, the Kronig-Penney model, and then one more concept will be coming about EK diagram. In these three concepts, so many equations are there which you will be requiring to remember. But just understand the basics so you can actually write down in the examination well. Okay. So the previous equation's solution is this one. Okay. Now there will be graphs coming in this. So basically, first of all, we need to understand the sine and cosine value. This is basic mathematics, okay, which you have gone through in 11th and 12th also. Normally, what happens, you can see the minimum range of cosine function is basically minus 1, okay, over 0 to 2 pi. We are considering over 0 to 2 pi only. So it is from minus 1 to 1. Similarly, for sine also, it is minus 1 to 1. Only the angles will be different, right? So here what happens, we have to draw the graphs for all of three here. Why? Because we are actually calculating the energy band wave into the rectangular approximation, right? So now what we have to do, some graphs will be made here. We have to convert this whole thing into some rectangular pattern. So how it will be done? So first of all, we have to draw the graph of this P sine alpha A upon alpha A. What is this? It has been given in this equation, this entity, the first one. Okay. So if I draw a wave for this, then it will be done like this. You can see for zeroth value, it is higher. Okay. For this value, it's getting higher. Why it is changed? Because P is also getting multiplied here. Also, it's in the division alpha A. Okay. So some wave pattern for the first equation's terminology is this. Now the second terminology was plus cosine alpha A. You can see here in the equation, we were having this second entity, okay, that is the basic cosine function, okay. So in the cosine function, you can see for the cos 0, the value is 1. Here, no multiplication is there, you can see. For the 30 degree, it's root 3 by 2, okay. At the pi, it is minus 1, you can see. At the pi value, it has shown as minus 1, okay. These are the range minus 1 to plus 1, basic cosine function, right. So they have shown a wave for this also. All right. Now in the right side, you can see the third terminology, that is cosine KA. Okay. This K is also once again taken as a wave vector. This K is the wave vector number. A is again the interatomic distance. So for that, the function where I will be taking the cosine KA, that will be also again from minus 1 to 1 only. Okay. Whatever in the RHS, I'm not knowing the value of K. So I can't draw that graph actually because I have to obtain it. Right. So, but one assumption we can make, that on the right side, we are having a cosine function, okay? So for the cosine function, the value should be ranging from minus 1 to 1 only, okay? But here you can say, when I'm adding this 2, that value is not matching this. Means you can see this region is higher here, but this region is 1 here. So when I will be adding this 2, the LHS must be equal to the RHS, right? In this equation, if I'm drawing a graph for this, I'm drawing a graph for this, and I'm adding this 2, I must get this cosine function wave, which I'm not getting directly because I'm adding sine function into the cosine function. Okay. So the third graph, which is shown in the textbook, is for the addition of this 2 wave. Okay. So when I will be adding this 2 wave together, my graph will be something like this. You can see here, this value will be getting added to this. Okay. This first is getting added to second, so it will be more higher region here, you can see, right? Same way, this higher region is getting added to this, so it will be somewhat higher region here, right? So the final addition of the graph looks like this, right? Because both functions are getting added, sine as well as the cosine. Now, I have seen that on the right side, I'm having the cosine KA only. Means its ranges for the 0 to 2 pi will be over minus 1 to 1 only. So now I have mentioned the extra region in my graph, which are not in the limit minus 1 to 1. So you can see this shaded region are outside the values minus 1 to 1, which I should not consider in my final wave. Why? Because the equation solution suggests that on the right side, we are having the cosine. So for 0 to 2 pi, the values will be ranging from minus 1 to 1 only. Okay. So in this graph, where I'm getting these values, this will be considered as the rectangular pattern, means the allowed energy of the electron. And this extra region are actually the forbidden energy gap, where actually no electrons are there. Okay. That is how I will be getting this wave pattern converted to the rectangular approximation. The extra shaded regions are now taken as the forbidden energy gap. And this region, which are actually inside minus 1 to 1, will be converted into the rectangular pattern. So you can see in this figure, you can see, right? So this portion are considered as this. Whatever the extra value is there, you can see here the extra value is there. So it is considered as an energy gap. This has been shown as the energy gap. Okay. You can see here also some extra values will be there, that is considered as energy gap. So whenever I'm having the graph that is getting added by two terminologies, sine and cosine, it should match with the right side of the side cosine function. So that's why the extra region has been taken as the forbidden energy gap. Okay. So the final graph from the wave function can be considered like this, somewhat like this. Okay, so that is the assumptions of the chronic panel model. Basically, we found the first conclusion as permissible limit from minus 1 to 1. Why? Because at the right side, we were having this. How this equation came? We reformed the Schrodinger's equation for the rectangular wave pattern. We found the exponential function. And the solution with the boundary limit was giving me this equation. And its range from the right side is from minus 1 to 1. So that's why the energy bands were found, which were permissible energy bands where the electrons can be there. But if I want to find the forbidden energy gap, that was found beyond this limit, okay, from minus 1 to 1. So that was the conclusion one. What was the second conclusion? If I increase the value of alpha A, the energy states for the electron will also increase, which will getting increased in the term of bandwidth also. Okay, so it will be possible that if I'm actually getting more angle of incident for the, we can say, interatomic distance at that time, the wave pattern will be also increasing, the bandwidth and intensity will also be increasing. Okay, so this leads to increase of the distance between electrons and total energy. That is the second assumption. How this has came from the equation of cosine Ka and sine alpha A. Okay, that has come from this. And the third assumption is that we were actually multiplying P with the first term. Okay, it was P sine alpha A upon alpha A, right? So what if the value of P is infinite and what if the value of P is zero? If P is zero, the first element will be zero. You can see in this equation. Okay, when first, let us take the first case. If P is infinite, what will happen? Cosine alpha value will be, cosine Ka value will be alpha infinite. Why? Because here the P is infinite, so it is getting multiplied with this. So again, this will be also infinite. So infinite is getting added with this cos alpha. So again, it will give me some infinite value itself, right? So at that time, when this kind of function is there, it will be plotted on the graph like a steeper straight line. You can see here. Okay, why this is sharp straight line? Because if my P is infinite, infinite is getting multiplied with sine. So that is also once again infinite. Now I'm adding some of the cosine value regardless of whatever it is. It will definitely turn into infinite itself. So graph will be at that time rectangular approximation will be straight line only. And the second case, if the value of P is zero, means now in the multiplication it's zero, so this terminology will be zero. So I'm adding zero plus cos alpha A. So cos alpha A and cosine Ka will be similar. Okay. So at that time I will be having the graph like this, in which you can go through the rectangular approximation, right? Here this one is the higher value. Okay, here it's getting lower. Once again it's getting higher, once again lower. This kind of rectangular pattern can be there. So this is the chronic panel model, which allows me to find what are the energy gaps are there, how energy band is meaning, okay, in different potential. That is how this model is actually useful. Okay, so anyone is having any doubt till now in how this model has been there? Everyone is clear about that? Then you may ask the doubt if you are facing anyone. Okay. I'm allowing you all to unmute yourself also. You can definitely ask the questions also regarding this. Are the concepts clear from your side? Okay, so just let me ask. If any doubt is there, then please mention in the chat box or unmute yourself. Are the concept about density of state is clear? In the equation, minor updation was there. A is not acceleration for the electron potential. It is interatomic distance where the electron is traveling. When you are talking about sound wave, at that time only it is taken into consideration as acceleration. Okay. Okay, fine. So, yes, any doubts in this session? Are the concepts clear? See, we will also be covering the numericals as well. Okay, once this theory sessions will be over for the chapter one, we will be covering the numericals also. Okay. Yes. So 65, Tisha Shah, are the concepts clear? A 65 number, Tisha Shah is there. So can you see me what happens when electron is getting collided with ions? Yes, Tisha. What happens when electron is getting collided with the ions? Their energy becomes zero or higher? Okay, anyone, does anyone know the answer? What happens when electron actually gets collided with the positive ion? Yes, Dhruvi, 63 number. potential energy becomes. Yes, it becomes zero, right? Okay. Now the next concept regarding this, that when electron is moving in between the ions, so at that time their energy can be of varying lower or higher. What it will be when it's moving in between the ions? You can unmute yourself. Okay. Yes, energy becomes higher. Good. I'm getting the answers in the chat box. Nice, Shayan. Yes, Dhruvi. Okay. Yes, Rishti. Yeah. Okay. Yes, Vini, I got your answer also. Very nice. Okay. Okay, fine. So when I was converting this into the rectangular, the region where the potential energy is zero, that will be barrier or the potential well, what it will be, where the energy potential is getting zero. Yes, nice, Shayan. Yes. Okay. Some of the students are answering. Very good. Yes, Dev. Very nice. Okay. Where the energy is zero, it will be barrier, right? Yes. Yes. Good. Yeah. Got your answer, Kashish. Yes, Tisha. Right. Okay. So in the textbook, you have to update this diagram because they are showing the higher peak where the wave is getting lower. So just update that graph. Yes, Harshit, Smith. Very nice. All right. Now the next concept was about once again the Schrodinger's equation. Okay, so here we got the concept. A new equation was there, okay, which you have to remember for your examination, as well as we saw the final solution. So this was regarding the boundary conditions. You need to remember this because no supportive theories has been there in the textbook as well. So the concept you need to understand. All right, then we drew three diagrams. First one was the terminology regarding sine function. Second one was regarding the cosine. Okay, then we added these two. The final wave was generated where the value was exceeding the cosine function. But because we have to match the left-hand side with the right-hand side, okay, that's why the final value, which were getting beyond the range minus 1 and 1, we took that as energy gap. Okay, that is the forbidden energy gap. Rest of them are the permissible energy. Permissible in the sense the electron may have that energy, right? So this was the conclusions. First one was regarding the region where we found the energy gap. Second, if I increase the angle of incident energy, okay, definitely it will be getting increased. Bandwidth will be increased and also the value of P. Okay, that is how these things went. Also, we covered about the density of the states also, okay? In which we saw that this equation was getting changed. Okay, here the value of A is about interatomic distance, it's not acceleration. All right, so that's why we got this final equation also. So these concepts, I hope this one is also clear about the density of the states. Okay, we got so many equations. So these two portions are having a lot of equation, and the Schrodinger equation is also getting changed so many times. You can see here they are dealing with the potential here. Then initially assumption was made that inside the box, the potential is zero. You can see here, right? Inside the box, they took in the consideration that it may be zero. So here what happened, in between the ions, they have taken it as infinite. And at the ions, they have taken it as zero in the chronic Penne model. Means the limitation of this 3D potential well assumption was later on improvised. Okay, because we found one more formula for the Schrodinger, which we saw today. All right, so that is how I'm concluding the session now. Anyone is having any doubt? We are remaining with less than 1 minute. Okay, so all right, we will continue with the next session then. If any doubt is there, you may ask. Okay, at the institute, if you are not able to attend the lab session, okay, in the January, if it is not possible, you can attend it later on. Up till now, you have to only think about engineering plus for January month. So those who are not able, for them, different schedule will also be there in upcoming months. Okay. All right. So thank you so much, all of you. And you may leave. Okay.